What loophole did you exploit mercilessly? Years ago when I was a freshman in college, Papa John's ran a promo for the Super Bowl where, if you called the coin toss correctly, you would get a voucher for a free one-topping pizza. However, the only control in place was you could only enter the contest one time per email address. I created more than 60 emails. Half of them calling heads, half tails, 8, 3, 4, 6 weeks. I was also not what you would call healthy in those days. There were several vending machines at my school and around town that had an exploitable design flaw. You could take two bills and scotch tape them into one long bill, one face up and one face down. When you put the bill in the machine, it would read the first bill correctly and the credit would show up on the machine. Then it would try to read the second, but since it was upside down, it would then spit both bills back out, and I could buy what I wanted with the credit it read from the first bill. When I was younger, I had Family Link on my device. For those of you who don't know, Family Link is a standard family monitoring app, and one of the things it could do is lock down my phone during bedtime hours. If I unlocked my phone during this time, a screen would pop up that says time for bed, and I couldn't get past said screen until morning. However, young me quickly discovered that the phone needed to be connected to the internet, and I found that if I turned off my Wi-Fi and data, my phone would not lock. Even though I couldn't access the internet, I could still play the games already downloaded to my phone. So young me was a happy camper. Early 2000s version of this, my sister and I both had PCs as teenagers. When we would get grounded, my mother would take away the wireless mouse. My sister's best friend was a computer guy and taught us all the keyboard commands for everything. Story has a happy ending. He's now my brother-in-law. The coin-operated laundry in our dorm had vertical coin slots, and if you placed the quarters in the fingers of a latex glove and then placed them in the slots, you could hold the opening of the glove, push the handle in, and then withdraw it with quarters still in the slot. The machine would start and then simply repeat the process for every load you needed. People at my school would pry the panels off the back of the coin op and touch the wires together until the machine started. I don't know if this counts as a loophole, but when I was in high school, my buddy worked at Subway. This was when they had the rewards card that you filled out with stamps, and after 8 subs you got a free one. I guess the employees were supposed to trash them when they were redeemed, but he just put them all in a box. One day he gave me a box full of them, and I ate free subs until they discontinued the rewards card years later. The car wash station near my house. If you put in a quarter, it thinks it's a loony, Canada, and I can wash my car for 50 instead of $2. I have been using this method over 4 years. A supermarket in my town has a little bar inside of it that's run by the supermarket. They use the same payment system. The supermarket was running a coupon that took $3 off of every purchase, no matter how much money you spent. They were also having a sale at the bar, where pints of locally brewed stout were $1. Typically they'd be about $6. My friend and I bought 3 pints. Total price was $3.21, tax. Subtract $3 with the coupon. 7-cent pints of really good beer. Went home. Came back with a bucket. Bought 3 at a time. Spent just over $2 for 30 pints of beer. Had a great night. Tried to go back the next day, but they'd caught on and gotten rid of the coupon. When I worked at Target, I'd buy 2 to 3 games at a time. Some of them, I'd play for a few hours before deciding I didn't really care for it. Since the products were open, I couldn't return them to Target. I learned that Walmart would exchange the game for you, no questions asked, without taking the wrapping off the new game. So I'd take my opened games to Walmart, exchange them for unopened games, then take the unopened game back to Target and return it for the full price. Local pizza place gave me a coupon for a free up to 3 topping large pizza if I also ordered a $5.99 order of garlic knots. For the last year or so, I've called once or twice a month and placed / paid for the order over the phone. I then go in and pick up the pizza. They have yet to actually ask me for the coupon, so I just keep using it, and the code keeps working. I did ask the employee if they wanted the coupon early on, but the person at the counter said nah, F this place, and laughed. I thanked them, left, and never asked again. I usually never took the coupon when I worked in pizza places. S is overpriced anyway. I'll let you keep the coupon. You use it again. We still make money, and you return to order again. Makes sense to me. Last year my local burger chain had a promotion for 1 week where you could get a free order of fries. No strings attached. You went to the online store and there was a free fries item that you could add to the cart. Being a web developer, I took note of the exact network request made when you clicked add to cart. Basically the request looked like postcard itemid. 672, where itemid 672 corresponds to the free fries item. Well, after a week, they took the free fries off the menu. But, I still had the web request saved. And to my amazement, calling the request directly with the correct item, it still added the free fries to the cart. Now, a year later, I've claimed 30 plus orders of free fries, over $100 of value. Every time I go to order from the store, I cross my fingers praying it's not been fixed yet. But at this point, I'm not sure they ever will address this. On my first year of college, we used to go to a nightclub that included two consumptions with a ticket. So you paid the ticket and they gave you two receipts that you could exchange at the bar for whatever drink you wanted. Well, the receipt were printed with the very same machine model and with the same paper that the library in our college printed the receipt for returned books with. Every Friday we took a lot of books and returned them using the automated system at the library that would give us a receipt for us to prove that the book was returned. Later that night we'd give those receipts to the busy bartender that could not be bothered to check those were real. This went on for months. What are the odds, lol? I once got a card to put in my car window to allow me to park at an event. The wording on the card was vague and just pretty much said I was allowed to park there. I used it while I was in college to park in the closer teacher spots when I was in college. Parking passes were like $500 or something, but the fine for parking without a permit was only like $20 or something. And they didn't know who I was if I parked illegally, since my car wasn't registered with the university, so they couldn't make me pay anyway. So I parked for free on the rare occasions I drove to campus. If you work in education and have a EDUML address, you can almost always get student pricing on services that offer it: Amazon, Spotify, etc. My roommate and I during college made a golf club, which was just the two of us golfing twice a week. We would put in requests for flyers and then never put them up, or put up other clubs' flyers over ours. The school kept funding us, so we kept playing because we did all the paperwork to appear as a legitimate club. We would advertise our elections for treasurer and president, which was the two of us getting drunk at the local bar on wing nights, switching roles for the semester. I shot my best game, 83, my junior year. We got shut down senior year when they realized it was just the two of us. I regret nothing. One of my students' job had a grossly overpriced kind of Buno vending machine in the break room. One day I accidentally realized it opened like a normal fridge. I've eaten approximately a gazillion kind of Buno in the course of 2 weeks without telling anyone but my best coworkers. I would do the same thing. Those things are effing awesome. More of a glitch, I suppose. But when Redbox first started, their app was much less robust than now. My wife discovered if you added a movie to your cart then hit checkout, then back, it would keep the movie in your cart but change the price to $0. We rented probably 30 movies for free, a few each week, until they finally updated the app. At Burger King, a double cheeseburger meal cost more than at a cheeseburger meal for years. Pitch the two bottom buns and boom. Double cheeseburger. McDonald's was the same way. It was cheaper to order two cheeseburgers, fries, and a drink individually than it was to order the two cheeseburger combo. I have no idea if this is still the case, as I haven't been there in quite a while. We didn't have much money when I was a kid, but my mom ended up getting a timeshare at a local resort. It had a huge, amazing pool with a waterfall, hot tub, underwater speakers playing jazz. Basically a kid's dream of a pool. My mom would take me, my siblings, and my friends to swim there all summer long. We even had birthday parties there. Never actually stayed in the resort though. My mom would just say I have a timeshare if anyone ever stopped her. And I guess nobody ever checked if she was actually staying in the hotel lol. 1 GBP equals about 20 SZL. Swaziland currency, but the £1 coin is exactly the same shape and weight of the Swazi L1 coin. Vending machines in the UK would therefore accept L1 coins as £1. Let's just say I had many cheap snacks and train/tube tickets. When I was in high school, my friends and I discovered a horribly unhealthy extreme coupon buy. The store was running a promotion of $99 energy drinks. The same energy drink was simultaneously running a promotion of buy 10 energy drinks. Get $10 in store credit. We cleared out 3 stores over a summer break and spent $30. We did this so we could have 3 checkout lanes constantly scanning all of their inventory. When the managers caught onto what we were doing, they would go through the same stages. First, they'd make sure we weren't doing anything illegal. Make sure they weren't doing anything they could get fired for. Then they'd help us offload their entire stock. The next day we went to try it at a few other stores. But word got out of Discovery and the store shut the promotion down. I drank so much amp that summer. I remember staying up for 2 days running on nothing but amp and Doritus. We were out in the desert building jumps for our bikes in the Phoenix's heat. I threw up, went home and slept for like 16 hours. And gave away the last of my energy drink loot. To this day the thought of drinking an amp makes me feel uneasy. The ducks at the park are free. I'm just rolling in that free duck money now. Pet shop is a free zoo. In the winter of 1986 to 87, Holiday Inn, at least the ones in Knoxville, Tennessee, USA, was giving out these paper slips to the guests that basically looked like a scratch-off lotto ticket. It was based on the NFL's Super Bowl. This was the year the Giants played the Broncos. Anyway, on the sheet there were at least 9 choices to scratch off. Each choice was a silver-colored football that could be scratched off with a coin. And under one of the silver footballs was a free dinner at the hotel's restaurant. My father finagled his way into getting a big stack of those somehow. My dad, my twin brother, and I were holding them in front of a light bulb to where we could see which silver football we needed to scratch off to get a free dinner. Of course, since the light bulb made them practically see-through, each one was a winner. My parents, my brother, my sister and I went to the Holiday Inn in Knoxville, the one at the Cedar Bluff exit, numerous times, and had really awesome dinners in the restaurant. We did that until the expiration date of the sheets. We ate there so many times for several months it was crazy. We never stayed in a hotel room. Never. We just ate dinner there several times a week for months. When I was back in high school, my orientation was arts. So in my entire class there were tons of people that were good at drawing. We went partying, and in Germany they stamp your hand at some locations to show you've already paid entrance fee and that you're the appropriate age to get all the hard alcohol. 2 older classmates got their stamps and they came back out after 5 minutes. On the parking lot we copied the stamps. We had brought a pallet of different colored pencils for this. As the stamps changed daily, we all got in. Not me, but a customer of the store I worked at. Every week I would get a smoothie maker returned. Every week. Same model. After a few weeks of the service desk giving them to me, I asked why. Do you give me one of these every week? They said they didn't know. We had a no questions asked return/exchange policy. As long as you had your receipt. I found out it was the same person returning it every week. Then as I dug further, it was the same customer who owned a burrito shop in the same plaza we were in. I saw him in the store one day and I asked him, hey, if the smoothie maker breaks after a week, why do you keep getting the same one? To which he replied, it makes the consistency of the beef perfect. Give that man a medal. Cause he had balls of steel for that one lol. There was a NPC store in lineage to that would sell basic crafting materials. If you purchase 9,999,999,999 at one time, the price would overflow back to like 2 gold. Then sell the 99,999,999,999 items back to him. Rinse and repeat. There's a similar strategy in No Man's Sky. You buy one system's whole stock of an item. Go to another system and sell all your stock. which drops that item's worth on that system. Rinse and repeat. You end up selling at the highest and buying at the lowest cost. You have to make a big investment at first. But after a while the rewards are huge. A Walmart near my place accidentally marked a specific flavor of beef jerky as a dollar. I bought 70 bags over a week, until they fixed it. Pizza Hut partnered with a coupon book company. The coupon read, buy any one pizza, and get a second pizza of equal or greater value. Freezo for about 2 years I would order a medium cheese pizza, and get a large supreme for free. I traveled a lot for work. A lot. Europe. Hawaii. Asia. About once a month. 4 years. We could make our own travel arrangements, flights, hotels, you name it, using airline and hotel credit cards. I would book the more expensive flights, multiple segment flights, more expensive rooms, all to bank points. After I quit I took my girlfriend, now wife, to Europe 3 times. Only spent money on food. Flew business class, and stayed in some really pimp suites. Did the same thing at my old corporate job. I was low level, but still traveled twice a month domestically. You could use your personal cards, and get reimbursed, or use company card. I chose personal, because I'm good with my money, and never carried a balance. Racked up 500k AA miles and 350k Chase Ultimate Rewards points, by planning my trips accordingly and using promotions. One time AA had a promotion that, if you booked a flight and a hired hotel through them, they would give you 6x points. Chase had the same, and I would just milk it.